Today, brought to you by Amy, who offers great value cover you won't regret. Amy does.
Well, welcome back. We begin with breaking news in Melbourne. There is traffic chaos on one of the city's busiest roads after a car crash. Just one city-bound lane is open on the Bolte Bridge, with traffic stretching back to the Essendon Airport. Drivers are being told to expect heavy delays. Also breaking at 9, Donald Trump's company has been found guilty of tax fraud in a scheme hatched by top executives. The real estate, hospitality and resort operation headquartered at Trump Towers in New York could be fined more than $2 million. Trump has said the case against his company was part of a politically motivated witch hunt. Victoria Police have released horrifying CCTV as they hunt for three men involved in an armed home invasion. Isabella Stashkovsky is live with the details. Isa, police have just spoken.
Tracy, good morning to you. The Armed Crime Squad has spoken on Melbourne Radio just a few moments ago, describing this crime as an execution-style home invasion with an intent to kill, saying it is fortunate that this trio realised they had the wrong home before it was too late. They have released this CCTV from all the way back in late April with the hope that someone will notice these men, all these vehicles involved, and come forward to Crime Stoppers. That vision is truly terrifying. In it, you can see three men in balaclavas, two with guns, one with an axe, going towards a home. They shoot at that home, the front door and the front window, before that man with that axe starts striking that front door repeatedly. They then break inside the home and fire again at the man inside. He is 54 years old and lives at that house still in Strathmore. They then very quickly make their escape after realising that they had the wrong home. They get away in a stolen car, a black VW that was then later found burnt out. They make their way then from that crime scene in a white 2018 Mazda 3, according to police. That man who was inside at the time, remarkably, Tracy, physically, he is okay. However, police have just said this morning that he has received some extensive counselling and that he was extremely shaken at the time. We are expecting to hear more from police later this morning, around 11:30 or so, with a further update. But they are seriously appealing for anyone with any information to please come forward.
A traumatic ordeal for the victim. Isa, thank you.
The US Secretary of State has praised Australia's response to coercion by Beijing. Speaking after an annual meeting of the American and Australian defence officials, Secretary Blinken described the government's efforts as extraordinary. The two countries also discussed the AUKUS submarine arrangement. Police are still negotiating with a man on the Gold Coast 16 hours after he locked himself in a house in Labrador. Mia Glover joins us now from the scene. Mia, as we go into our 16th hour, what's the latest?
Yeah, you've got to really feel for police that have been here all night, David. But we have seen things just start to ramp up within the last 20 minutes or so. We've seen specialist officers arrive on scene here to try and get that man out of the townhouse. So we could see that develop in the next half hour or so. So that is some good news. But there have been three police negotiators on scene right throughout the night, just working tirelessly to get this man to try and surrender. The initial threat was that he had a gas bottle inside that home with him, he's there by himself, and that he was going to ignite it and make it explode. Of course, a lot of residents were forced from their homes overnight just as a precaution. Some have chosen to stay and lock themselves inside. The good news is this morning that exclusion zone has started to be relaxed, so police are allowing people in and out of the complex so they can go to work, they can go to school. We spoke to some people a short time ago.
What have you heard throughout the night?
Not much at all. Not much. They're keeping it pretty quiet.
Not much screaming or anything from the man inside the home?
No, I haven't heard anything. I just woke up this morning, saw that still there and went, still going on.
It's a bit confronting, yeah.
So like I said, David, those specialist officers are right now at the scene, at that townhouse surrounding that property. Hopefully we'll see some movement within the next half an hour or so.
It's a long time, isn't it? All right, thanks, Mia.
In a few hours, Prince Harry and Meghan will walk the red carpet at a human rights event in New York. Let's go live once again to our US correspondent, Jonathan Kersley. Jono, the couple are getting plenty of publicity ahead of their Netflix series, and that's not what they want, right? Publicity?
Oh, you wouldn't have thought so, would you? A little over 36 hours away from this docuseries finally making its way to the airwaves, Prince Harry and Meghan touching down in the Big Apple ahead of their big night. All smiles, they are going to be recognised by the Robert F. Kennedy Foundation for work on human rights, largely around fighting against racial injustices, but also for pushing issues on mental health, services that indeed are worth recognising. But this does all come around about 36 hours or so before the release of their Netflix series. This has been much talked about. It has certainly garnered plenty of publicity over the course of the last week or so. It's worth around about 140 odd million Australian dollars to the couple. But already there have been some questions around whether the trailers have been entirely truthful, whether they are misleading. And now there is a publicity battle royale going on. Well, there's these trailers on one hand. On the other side of the Atlantic, you've got the Prince and Princess of Wales releasing some touching images from their eco-friendly Earthshot Prize Awards ceremony here in the United States just last week. And right now they are attending a reception at Buckingham Palace with King Charles and Queen Consort Camilla to recognise and thank ambassadors and high commissioners. So there's a publicity game certainly being played on both sides. The palace has been quiet about the Netflix series. That might change by the end of the week.
Yeah, I think it probably will. All right, Jono, thank you. That's all I've got to say.
I think you actually have a lot more to say, but not on camera. A quick hit of entertainment for you guys now. Eric Banner hit the blue carpet last night, the Aussie actor attending the Sydney premiere for his new film, Blueback. Blueback follows the story of a young girl who befriends a wild blue groper and is based on Tim Winton's novel of the same name. It does look really good. It will premiere in cinemas January 1st. Finally, it's official. The Corrs are returning down under. The group announcing their Australian national tour this morning. The group will be joined by special guests Natalie Imbruglia and Tony Childs. Concert dates are on the screen and tickets go on sale Tuesday, December 13th at 9 a.m. local time. They're a blast from the past.
What a great gig that's going to be.
I'm
going to be there doing your Irish dancing.
No, I'm going to be there doing my Tony Childs impersonation. No, love that.
We got him to sing.
There we go.
On that note, carry it on for today. Extra now with Tim and Belinda.
We're going to be singing that all day, guys. Happy hump day to you all, Belinda.
Perhaps if you're not in Bali, though. Not happy hump day.
Oh, you know. Yes, the bonk band. We'll get into that a little bit later. For you this morning, though, pre-Christmas pain. The RBA issues another interest rate blow, the highest level seen in a decade. This morning, what it means for your mortgage.
Also today, tributes pour in for Emmy Award-winning actress Kirstie Alley. We are live to Hollywood as friends and fans remember the much-loved Cheer star.
Royal Insider, an intimate look at the life of Queen Elizabeth II. Renowned royal biographer Andrew Morton reveals all on the woman behind the crown.
Can't wait for that chat. British Bake Off superstar Nadia Hussain drops by. How you can bake yourself happy this festive season.
Yes, please. And Brendan Fraser's fairy tale comeback.
Do you ever get the feeling that people are incapable of not caring?
How the Hollywood star climbed his way back to the top, even creating Oscars buzz. That's all ahead for you this Wednesday, the 7th of December, 2022.
Yes, thanks so much for your company this morning. But first is some sad news out of Hollywood yesterday with the news of Emmy Award-winning actress Kirstie Alley passing away aged 71.
Entertainment reporter Sam Rubin joins us live from Los Angeles. Sam, how are friends and fans importantly remembering Kirstie Alley?
Well, I think there's two things, Tim and Belle. First, there was just shock. People did not know that she was ill, and this was a real surprise. It dropped here in Hollywood yesterday in the late afternoon. This message posted on her Instagram account from her son and daughter announcing her passing.